Welcome back to the Sioux Falls Arena. Class A State Wrestling Championships. We're at the 140-pound weight division. Number two versus number three in this match. Number two-ranked Griffin Hebe of Aberdeen taking on third-ranked Logan Smith of Yankton.
Last year, well, Hebe's a region three champion, ESD champion. Smith was seventh last year at 130. He was a region two champion. So we got two champions here together.
They've met each other once this year. Smith defeated Hebe earlier.
Yankton's having a pretty good tournament, you know.
Yankton is
better, was in here a little bit ago, and so they're having a good tournament.
Yankton looking to go 2-0 with wrestlers in the finals. Pierre had two wrestlers in the finals. They both got championships with Montfort and Paulson.
And Montfort being a very excited one. Okay. He had a front headlock hooked up, couldn't convert it.
Logan Smith of Yankton in the red singlet. Hebe of Aberdeen in the white. Hebe looks a little bit taller.
Yep.
A little taller wrestler.
Tried a little throw by there. Okay, he's got a 2-on-1 on that arm. He's got trying to break him down, spin behind. All right, he's got a front headlock, and Hebe gets out of it nicely. See, you normally tell your kids you don't really want to tie ear to ear because you get tied up and you can't move. You want to be forehead. Oh, nice little spin move. Didn't. Oh, and he hooked the single. Some great shots and counter shots. Smith tried to spin. Hebe caught a leg. You want to tie up forehead to forehead, not ear to ear. You get tied up ear to ear and you can't move. And that stops and inhibits things. So go forehead to forehead, you get more movement. Well, trying to gain position, trying to knock his hands down, trying to get. Smith's got an arm tied up. He's trying to spin behind, caught the chin. And exact reversal positions. Hebe's got a front headlock on. You want to try and snap him down, put your head in his armpit and spin behind. Well, his first period's been going fast. Seems like it just started. It's a blur and it's over. And these are 2-minute periods, not one.
Not a lot of points, though, Coach.
No, well. You know, you're feeling the other guy out, and unless you're deciding, you know. Okay, Hebe won the flip, he deferred, Smith takes down. Let's see what Smith does. See if he explodes or covers and attacks hand. What's he gonna do? All right, gotta stand up. He's trying to has to return him. Ooh, there we go again. I would bet probably Smith's going to stand up again. But right on the whistle. Well, then he crunched him forward. Now, Hebe's got his arm tied up. He's got him flat. But Smith got to his base. Trying to turn. Hebe, you got to. The guys get like that, and you better stay under both arms, or they'll turn on you. All right, he's up. He's going to get pushed. Oh, he controlled him again. That's a nice counter by Hebe.
Nice upper body strength.
Yeah, he's doing a very good job of controlling him. Uh-oh, here we go. Can he get his hips down and get his leg back and free it? Hebe's going to stay there. It'll probably hang for a stalemate.
Yeah, this will be a stalemate here, probably.
He's trying to get him tipped. He's trying to pull the leg in. He's going to put a cross face on. Let go of the cross face. Oh, look at that. He broke the grip. Step over. He's got two. The minute you step over like that, that's two. Well, Hebe's got to go now. He's down 2-0. 51 seconds to go in this period.
I think we both thought it was going to end up in a stalemate.
Yeah, I did too.
And Smith just kept at it.
Now, so he's got an over and under. That's a good move. You get. Reading pick his legs up there, and it's all right. Hebe's going to come up. They're on the edge of the mat. He tied up an arm. See what Smith did? Always try and tie an arm if you can. And he's going to sit right there for about 20 seconds. Ride him out. got the arm all the way across the body trap. He's trying to turn him.
When are they considered off the mat? Sometimes the legs get out leg, all around
you know,
the circle. And
two guys lay on the foot of another guy, or sometimes you get them both out, but half the body is in. It's kind of a judgment. That's why I said, I wish we'd go to the college rule. If you got anything at all, either one in, then you just let them wrestle. This way, is he in or out? Called it too soon, you didn't call it quick enough. It's...
Nice shot of the coaches from Yankton and Aberdeen. They've seen each other a lot here during this wrestling season.
Looks like Smith's kind of shifting gear on Heave now.
Logan Smith from Yankton in the red singlet. He leads it 2-0 over Griffin Heave of Aberdeen in the white. Griffin's going to need a takedown if he wants.
He's got to have a takedown. Oh, Smith's in on a single. Heave sprawls and they're going to end up off the mat. Yep. Heave has to go. I mean, he's down. He's got to go. And by the same token, Smith has to keep wrestling. Keep pounding on him. Keep him off balance. Pick up a cheap takedown if you can. But keep attacking.
There, like that.
He caught him. Look, that happens. No loss of balance. Leap on him. Now it's 4-0, and he rode him out last period. I would suspect he's got the arm tied across the back.
Smith digging that head into the back of Heave.
He's got a chicken wing on. He's going to try and get him turned. Let's see how he's worked this. There's a number of things you can do from there. He's going to try to turn the bar. Now he's got it.
45 seconds to go in the match.
See, it's tough when you got your arm up on your back. You can't even get up. So he reaches for an arm bar and he turns. He's got a chicken wing on one side. Stalemate, all right? Heave has got to explode.
He needs to escape, a reversal, whatever, takedown.
Escape and a takedown and kick him. He's got to take him down twice. Escape and takedown, only give him 3 points. He's trying to hook up a roll.
30 seconds.
Time is running out for Griffin Heave of Aberdeen.
Oh, he's got his arm across his back again. You have to be careful. Could be. Oh, he's going to try to call a country boy. Now, he may just ride, or he might go right around the front and turn him on his back.
Final seconds at
140. He's just going to stay right there.
Logan Smith of Yankton is going to be your champion at 140.
Yep, there it is.
Yankton got two champions tonight already. They tie Pier with the two champions in Class A.
Okay, here we go.
Let's check our public address announcer, Jamie Smith.